Bigger was the
collagen.
Collagen. It was like kissing a rock or something. I can tell yours are very natural, very soft.
Ouch.
Something wrong?
Just your segue.
Yeah. Look, I feel really awkward here because what I want to say I can't say without sounding like a typical male jerk. I want to kiss you. There, I said it. Ow! I don't know if it's the drinks or this dive bar or this insane New York day, but you're beautiful and sexy, and I have read too much Hemingway.
Wow, you know, there are so many ways to get laid. This just doesn't strike me as the easiest.
Oh, this isn't about getting laid. Mm-mm. This is about being in the moment. Sure. I want to make it with you, baby, but that's the moment. You see?
I do see. You know what? You are absolutely right. Let's do it. Not just the kiss, but the sex act in its complete entirety. We could go back to your place, and we should make it fast because I do have dinner plans. But oh, before we go, there's one thing I should tell you, and this makes me feel a little awkward, but you should know I'm a virgin. Shocker, isn't it?
A virgin.
And I could give you a whole War and Peace list of reasons as to why I'm still a virgin, but I just don't think it's that important. But since you will be my first ever, you better have some great sex chops because I have waited so long. The buildup in my head is astro extraordinary. And to put it bluntly, you better rock my world. Send me into orbit. Plummet me into the next dimension, because at this point, it is all about total satisfaction. Do we have a deal?
I have dinner plans too. I should probably take a rain check. But call me. My shoes run out the door, rushing to the job I hate. And the ticket on my windshield's no surprise. The truth is out, it's murder. I hear what life's about is so unclear. I want to break, and when it feels I've had all I can take, hear what you and you make.
Try this on. You guys are far too good to me. Oh, what time's the party?
There's no party.
Who said party?
Uh-huh. Nice try.
Who told her about the party?
We've thrown her one every year since college, like she's not gonna know.
Hey, where is she?
In the back.
Oh, you are not gonna believe who I ran into this morning.
Hey, Sammy.
Hey, Sam.
Guys, you are not gonna believe this. I was in Monica's Deluxe picking up the cake when, passing by the window, I saw Tyler Swindell walking by eating a vendor bagel.
No way.
That's what I said. It can't be. Not Tyler Swindell, Eastland stud, man about campus. Not here, not in New York City. I mean, hell, I haven't even seen him since what? Donnie dumped him back in college?
Shh. Oh. Was it him?
Yes, it was him. And I chased him down 7th Avenue, carrying that triple fudge mud cake 3 blocks till I caught up with him.
I thought we were going with the vanilla strawberry.
Oh, the mud cake surpasses.
What's Ty doing in New York?
He lived here 3 years now.
I don't believe it.
Can't believe he hasn't called us.
Oh, how did he look? Gorgeous as ever.
Same cute butt.
I always wanted him.
Thought you had him.
No, I was one of the few that didn't graduate with that honor.
And Donnie.
I chatted with him just a little bit, but you guys can catch up with him all you want to later, because I invited him tonight.
You what? You invited him?
Yeah, he's our friend.
Sam, he and Donnie ended ugly.
Yeah, she's gonna kill you.
What do you think? What?
Broken angel, take that plane and finger paint the sky till everything.
No one votes anymore. The internet, cell phones, all of these forms of communication have turned us into a non-communicative generation.
And your thesis will discuss the reasons your generation seems lost and inactive?
Take me, for example. I'm 25 years, actually 26 today, and profoundly lost as a human being. I spent my entire life in school. My parents still support me. Human relationships baffle me, and I am acutely self-aware to the point where I'm clueless and slightly suicidal.
And you represent today's generation?
Yes, absolutely. Professor James, in generations past, the window into adulthood began at 18, and now it's 30. A second coming of age, if you will. A void post the teen years that we are drowning in.
You say that you're part of this non-communicative culture. So how are you going to provide some new insight?
I'm going to offer you a course of action. I believe that this second coming of age is representative of a kind of barrier, a wall that we hit, a manifestation of a certain type of fear that immobilizes us. For some, it's professional. For others, it's relational, emotional, sexual, etc. In order to deal with these fears, we operate within this fantasy world that we've constructed around us. Only by conquering those fears, ripping ourselves from the comfortable protection of this fantasy world, can we initiate the passage into adulthood. Professor James, I will live and breathe this thesis.
Everything looks good. The sun is shining on me today. Everything looks good. For a change, for a change.
Interesting.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Very interesting.
Of course, we can't sign you. I just want to say that up front. I'm very upfront. Artists appreciate that about me. But the last thing we in the world needs is another Matchbox 20 / Baron Naked / Dave Matthews / Fastball / Male Alanis. You know? This lyric-driven thing is decidedly over.
And who decided?
But it was interesting, your music, the lyrics, the melody, the chords was...
Was what?
Well, it was interesting because it was just missing. In every category, across the board, just missing.
Just missing.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, really, big time just missing. You know, it was close, but it was just missing.
Right, right.
Thanks for coming by, Randy.
Vandy.
I'm glad you enjoyed the show. Thanks for watching.
Cole, I can't believe she lied to you about Derek.
She's nasty that way.
We talked last night till 2 a.m. I'm falling hard. Think you might be the one.
Really? Excellent.
You are such a babe.
Cigarette.
There you go. Hi. Who would you like me to make this out to?
You don't remember?
I'm sorry. Do I know you?
Uh-huh.
I apologize, but...
You picked me up one night, a couple months ago.
I think you have me confused.
160 West 68th Street, apartment 2C. He had a roommate. We kept quiet. Now I know why you didn't call.
Hi. Actually, I haven't seen Ty since we were roommates in college.
That's right. You two are the big studs on campus.
Things have changed.
Yes, they have. You guys will just have lots to talk about.
You peed all over the Essex house.
That's what you get for representing an orangutan.
He was the star of the movie.
My date.
Kurt. Hi.
Hi.
What's the birthday girl's name again?
Donnie.
Donnie, right.
That's outstanding.
Stop gawking.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Mm. How was your audition?
Sam is looking good tonight.
Poor little lovelorn puppy. Mm. How long have you been pining away for her now? 10 years?
Longer than that, you're forgetting high school.
Oh, right. The forgotten years.
Oh my God, is that Ty?
I can't believe it! Mr. St. James! How are you doing?
Actually, I live with Donna.
Oh, you guys hooked up. Should've known.
No, we're just roommates. More like a sister, really.
Where is she?
Hiding from you. How about you? You single?
Still non-committal as ever.
So I'll call you tomorrow, right?
Hey.
Are you drunk? Because I don't feel like being trapped in the kitchen. I'm alone and unarmed.
No, I come in sober peace. I learned my lesson.
Did you? You're here.
I just wanted to say congratulations. I heard you got the job.
Thanks.
And I thought maybe I could take you out to dinner. You know,
nice
celebrate.
Try.
No, I mean it. Strictly friends.
If I thought you could define it as a friend outing, I'd love to. But since I have years of experience that says otherwise, I'm gonna politely decline.
Quit drinking.
Really?
You said it was becoming a problem, so I gave it some considerable thought. And I think you were right. So I quit.
That's good, Van. I'm happy for you. I am.
And I thought maybe we could take a stab at a friend thing. You know, move forward.
Show too much enthusiasm.
I was ignoring you.
Really?
Look, I'm sorry you took me by surprise. It's been a long time.
6 years.
I knew we'd run into each other eventually. Fate does that.
Here we are. Fated. I hope this isn't too bad for you. I really wanted to see you.
I've often wondered what it would be like to see you again. Kind of planned it in my head, rehearsed it, actually. What exactly I would do, whether I would have the strength to say what I really wanted to say, do what I really wanted to do.
And?
Represent District Attorney Kerry Thomas. His office is upstairs, but you'll rarely see the man. You're what we call a peon, a grunt. Think fast, be quick on your toes, and get out of the way.
Out of the way. Got it.
Take this case file, 20 copies by lunch.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Tell me something, Price. Is that accent for real?
Is it a problem?
Only if you plan on keeping it.
Yeah, it's
me.
I'm not talking to you.
Oh, you're mad at the wrong person. Hold on, let me conference Sam.
Sam Price.
It's me.
I only have a second.
Is everyone on?
Sam, how could you?
Didn't Ty look good? That would be yes.
But you needed closure.
You slapped him good.
Total closure.
Maybe the slap was premature.
Yeah, maybe he's changed.
Please.
You're right. He still had that dripping raw sex thing going.
So what are you gonna do?
I did it. The impulse is over. It's not over. That slap was a beginning.
I'm hanging up. Wait. There's more. Sam, what did I hear about you going out with Vandy?
Okay, you shouldn't smoke. It's not flattering.
You're avoiding.
It's my first date.
Do you guys think in your late 20s there's a second coming of age? I'll call you back.
Later.
Why'd you cut out early last night?
Your party, your friends. Got a little weird, you know.
Are we on for tonight?
I got a cocktail thing with Jerome. He was smoking.
Kiss me anyway.
Just remember to surface slowly. While you're coming up, exhale the whole time.
Or your vessels will expand and explode through your forehead?
Yeah, something like that.
You like this? Teaching?
For the most part. I think I'd like to do more, though. How's Donnie?
Confused, bipolar. I blame you.
I really screwed that up, man. I was such a jerk in school.
Now you've changed?
I'd like to think so. Haven't you?
So, how come no one's heard from you all this time?
I kind of been doing the whole loser thing. I didn't see any reason to flaunt it.
That was dumb.
Come on, man. It's weird. You're like this big, hot soap stud I couldn't even imagine.
You have no idea.
So tell me, you still getting all the chicks?
Actually, I'm gay. No, really, I am. I'm a raving homosexual. Completely closeted, fearful of exposure, but gay nonetheless. I have been my whole life. Just can't seem to deal with it.
God.
Not like freaking out right now, are you?
Nah. It's cool. It's cool, man.
Well, my first day wasn't exactly a picnic. Every time I opened my mouth, you'd think I was this freak in a sideshow. I don't think these people have ever met anybody from the South.
You're kidding.
So this friend thing could work, right?
Maybe. If you would stop referencing it and let it happen.
Right, one question and I'll stop. Why? When did I stop being love interest material and fall into the friend category?
Vandy, give it a rest. I was enjoying us for the first time in a long time.
Just consider this a station break. We'll get back to the friend thing in a minute.
All right, you really want to know?
Mm-hmm.
The unabridged truth.
Mm-hmm.
We're not in the same space. Everybody gets to a point in their lives when reality bites them on the ass. And you haven't been bitten. You lack drive, focus, and ambition. You're still living in a dreamland.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to get my career off the ground.
But you're not. You're a bartender. And that's okay, but when do you sing? Hmm? You tinker. You dabble. You never really pursue
it. I am always pursuing it, Sam.
You talk about it, but you don't do it. Do you realize that since you've been in New York, I haven't heard one song that you wrote? You've never even sung one note around me, not since college. What is that about?
Okay. Station break is over.
I'm gonna expose this whole pre-30 wasteland that we're living in. I'm gonna show how our almost paralyzing fears can actually motivate us into true adulthood.
I love the way your cynicism masquerades as optimism.
I couldn't have said it better.
That's because your cynicism is merely hiding your optimism.
Bag. I'll get it.
It's, Ty.
Answer it.
No, you answer it. I'm not home.
Ooh, I gotta go to the bathroom.
Me too. No, Russell! Jesse! How did you get in the building?
Someone was leaving?
That would be you.
Oh, wait. I have something for you.
Thank you.
Donnie, how do you hate after all these years?
I just remember how you swore your love and fidelity to me endlessly and then proceeded to screw everyone inside except me.
You were a virgin. You weren't ready.
And that gave you license.
No, I was wrong, but how can I apologize if you won't give me a chance?
Go ahead.
I messed up. And I knew how special you were, but I was too stupid and young to be fair to you. I couldn't commit, Donnie, and it was wrong and selfish and stupid of me, and if there's any way I could take it back, I would. It's the one thing I wish I could change. The hurt I saw in your eyes the day you found out. It's the same hurt that you have in your eyes right now. I'm sorry. Please, forgive me.
Love, you get enough tears to fill an ocean. That's what you get for your devotion. I never fall in love.
Hello,
it's me.
Do your fantasies make you inactive somehow?
Huh, you slapped Ty twice now. That's active.
He deserved it.
Well, I think you should call him up and ask him out.
Not in this life.
You obviously have some unresolved feelings for him.
No, they'll pass.
Call him.
I guess I don't have to hate him.
You have the perfect in. I mean, you know, call him up, apologize for slapping him, and then ask him to dinner.
Maybe.
I have his number.
I'm still at the maybe phase.
Well, work it through. You know, ask yourself, what is it that you really want out of life?
I want someone to brush my teeth with each night.
Hold on a sec. You there?
Mm-hmm. Are you calling?
Guess.
Hello?
Ah, you bitch.
Excuse me?
Hi, Ty.
Donnie.
I'm sorry I slapped you twice. It was inappropriate, and I thought maybe we could have a civil conversation sometime. Maybe I could cook you dinner some night.
I'm free tonight.
Oh, tonight's not...
Great.
Hello?
Great. 8:00. No violence, I promise.
I'll be there.
Bye.
Bye.
Done.
I'm gonna castrate you.
I'll never fall in love again. Don't tell me what it's all about. Cause I've been there.
Sorry about the other day. The job thing kind of, you know.
No, I don't know.
What kind of gets in the way?
Well, if you're gonna sleep with people you don't know, you gotta be ready for anything.
I'm sorry I didn't call you. We had a good time that night.
You lied to me. Told me you were a doctor.
I am, on the show. Look, wait. I'm sorry. Can I make it up to you? See you sometime?
You've obviously mistaken me for a closeted, dysfunctional, socially unenlightened, noncommittal, confused, unevolved homosexual. That would be you.
Check your stats with Ferguson. Tell Peter's no quote wouldn't be in the DA's best interest. He's looking bad enough. And give me a reservation for 2 at Nobu, 8:00.
For Thomas?
put it in my name. That's it for now.
Are you taking your wife out? I noticed the ring.
You're from North Carolina, right?
Born and bred.
No kidding.
Do you have a problem with the South?
No, it's nothing regional. It's just that I would have preferred someone qualified for the job.
Excuse me?
Well, your dad and Thomas were old college buddies, weren't they?
I can do this job.
Who are we fooling here, Price?
Well, I might just surprise you.
Oh, you do that. But first, why don't you try and make that bottom lip stop quivering? Or better yet, when you walk out that door, why don't you see if Daddy's little girl can keep from falling apart?
Have an adverse reaction, aim for the other cheek. The left one's a little sore.
Thanks.
I only want you doing national press, no regional. Hey, Morgan, can I call you back?
Jesse. Hi. Wow. This is most unfortunate.
I'll say. Hi. I'm Jesse.
Hi.
I'm Kurt's sponsor, and I'm gonna have to end this date right now. You promised me no women for 90 days.
Excuse me?
You're not aware of Kurt's condition?
Who is she?
Jesse, don't do this.
Kurt is sexually dysfunctional and a recovering sex addict. I'm his sponsor from Sexually Compulsive Anonymous, SCA. And Kurt, you're breaking like three of the steps at this moment. No dates. I mean, you know where this leads. You're just gonna flatter her and charm her and take her to bed and have sex with her all night long, and in the morning you're gonna leave her. And then where will you be?
You're such a bitch.
This is so insensitive of you. I mean, how could you do this to this poor girl with bad hair? He has a total lack of sensitivity and fear of intimacy. Kurt, you've got to take the power away from your penis. Repeat after me. You are powerless over your penis.
I'll be right back.
You are powerless over that penis.
Excuse us. What are you doing?
My question.
I'm on a date with another woman.
Duh.
I knew you were the kind of girl who'd snap.
Well, then you shouldn't have crossed me. I'm deadly.
We are not in a monogamous relationship. We never discussed exclusivity.
Fine, fine. Date whoever you want, but you lied about it, and that's wrong.
You forced me to lie to you. You don't leave any room for the truth. You suck the air dry. I can't take it anymore. You are far too toxic. I'll see you.
In other words, it's a bogus science.
No, no, anthropology is necessary to understand how humans function. We would be lost without it.
You're implying that we're not?
Okay, I could argue this better without wine. I got it.
Sorry.
Don't apologize, you'll get hit.
So how many degrees will this make for you?
Just one. I keep hopping.
You remember our first date? Cooked for me in your dorm room on a hot plate. And we rented a movie.
Dirty Dancing, I was reminded earlier.
And then we began what would become our theme song.
Don't even think about it. Thank you.
doesn't answer?
Oh, no, boy.
And if he still doesn't answer?
I simply say, baby.
For dinner. Glad you called. More stupid than that.
I'm not a very smart girl. I dumped Kurt.
Another one bites the dust.
Too controlling, I couldn't breathe. Then I'm toxic to my soft nature.
Wanna get drunk?
Yeah.
Surprise me.
You want another surprise? I'm a virgin.
Really?
Bonafide. Don't exactly know why, but I am.
But how?
I was waiting. You know that. You heard it firsthand. I wasn't ready. And then I was ready, and the opportunity didn't present itself. And then it did, and I wasn't ready again. And then I just kept waiting and waiting and waiting and made such a big deal out of it that it never happened. Anyway, here I am. Take me.
But Donnie,
won't take no for an answer. I'm 26, Ty. It's time.
Hey.
clean boxers.
Hey.
Hi.
Sorry.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
So you're the mysterious stranger. You heard Donnie pouncing on someone. You're on good terms, I hope. No fist fighting.
Not yet.
It's early.
Russell, how do I do right by her?
Be kind, be honest. That's what people deserve.
What are you doing here?
I wanted to see you. I owe you an apology, Vandy. I shouldn't have said the things I said about your music. It was insensitive and judgmental, and I'm sorry.
Not a good day, huh?
I just want you to be happy, Van. And if music does that for you, I'm glad. Now I just have to figure out what's gonna make me happy.
And you think this new career move is your answer?
I don't know. But it's a job. A real job with real people, and they're adults. It's not like we're still in college. It's just not cool to be that struggling artsy couple anymore.
Well, that sounds like a direct quote from your father.
No. Just me. I don't find the struggle attractive anymore, Vandy. It's time for the real part.
But why does that have to exclude me and us?
It wasn't working, Vandy. We stopped being good together. You know that. And I don't know how to change that around until I change myself. I just wanted you to know that I am sorry.
Yeah. Me too.
Good night, Vandy. I'm glad you quit drinking, Van.
Sorry. I want you to understand something. I'm not rejecting you here. It's just you laid something so monumental on me.
Who wants the pressure? I get it.
No. This has as much to do with me as it does with you. See, you've given me a chance here. I can be noble. I've never done that before, and I don't think it's a mistake that you've walked back into my life at this point. No, really. Listen, I've been kind of lost for these last few years. And it's kind of hard to explain, but I have to change.
What if I want to change?
I know this isn't how you remembered me, but I don't want to be remembered like how I was.
You're in a second coming of age.
Yeah, I guess. I should have been there a long time ago.
And the problem is that I'm still in my first. You should go.
For coffee sometime?
Right now, I want you dead.
And I should go.
Be ready for...